Hi, I'm Leif Johnson. I'm associate editor at Macworld, and today I'm going to show you the Razer Core X. This is a new external graphics processing unit that Razer released just on Monday, and I've actually been trying it out for a few days here, but the main thing, I want to show you how simple it is to use this thing. The whole point of an eGPU is to basically boost the graphics processing capability of your MacBook or, you know, one of Razer's own thin laptops, but since we're Macworld, we're mostly interested in how it works with a Mac. So the problem is that you can only use AMD cards. You can't use Nvidia, which is a real bummer, especially if you're wanting to use this for gaming. So we've got a whole article talking about the pros and cons of this. But right now, let's show you how to set it up. It's so easy. So the neat thing is, you generally, when I've seen other external graphics processing units, they're really difficult. You got to do all this unscrewing this. Look at this. That's all you gotta do. You just simply pull that out. So what we do is we have an AMD RX 580 right here. This is a pretty good.
Let me jump on the other side of you.
Yeah, go ahead. That's a pretty good card. So what we'll do here, the only screw that you have to worry about is this one right here. And like I said, usually there's about four. So you simply put it in. I think I maybe got it.
And it's effectively just a PCI Express slot in it,
exactly,
right?
Yes. And the thing is, it can actually fit one that's three wide, which is one of the big appeals. And it also has a 600, there we go. It has a 650 watt power supply, which means that, you know, this thing can keep you going for the next couple of years. And of course, I would do that.
How many watt power supply did you say?
650 watts.
Okay, yeah. But it can only handle one card. It's only one slot, right? It's not like a dual slot,
right,
SLI.
But it can do a really big card at the same time. And the nice thing is you can see the fan here. You can switch it out. So if this one's not powerful enough for you or something like that, or it wears out, nice thing is, unlike most Macs, you can customize it and switch out to one you want. So I'm pretty good with that. This, you know, I had a feeling I was going to mess it with this on the show. So
it's a little tight for your fingers.
Yeah, it is. So there we go, got that in. Now this is the roughest part of it. And like I said, though, this is just a single screw, whereas I've seen others where you gotta worry about four or something like that. And boom, that's it. And so we're just gonna put the wires in here.
Power supply.
Yes. Got that. And then bring this one over here. Now, when I first opened this, you know, this isn't like an unboxing or anything. These were very tightly up against here, so I had to undo that. So that added a little bit more time, but not much. So basically, we're ready to go. So what you do, you know, you just do that, locks it. And so now we find our power supply cable. And see, the thing is, this is only $299. The way they did get around that is the V2 that Razer also sells would normally have like two USB ports here, Ethernet port. Here, all you got is the Thunderbolt 3 / USB-C port and the power cable. That's it. Everything else is on the graphics card.
And it has, is this a window or is this just a mesh screen?
It is just a mesh screen. Okay. It's just a mesh screen. So, and you know, Razer stuff usually has all the swanky chroma lighting, which makes it look all cool and stuff. You won't get that with this, but
so
that's fine.
You just plugged in the USB-C?
Yes, I did.
Okay.
And now I'm plugging it in to the MacBook. And basically, we are set to go. So if you've never actually used one, the problem with a external graphics processing unit, especially on a Mac, is it only works with an external monitor. So we'll plug in the HDMI cable right here.
So you can't use it for any internal graphics acceleration or anything like that?
No, not at the, apparently it's possible, you know, if the developer wants to do it or something like that, but that's it. But let's see, did we turn on here? That would help. Yes, you simply turned it on. Now there was one thing, nice thing that I noticed, that it's, you know, I was actually worried that it wasn't plugged in when I was first messing around with this. Turns out the fans and everything don't even start running until you actually plug it in. It's like it didn't even turn on. So,
yeah, look, no lights yet.
Look ahead at the screen. The nice thing about Apple support, and I didn't have to install any kind of drivers or anything like that. See, it's already connected. That's what you have to do. And the nice thing is if I wanted to disconnect that, you know, just do it like a drive, you know, it goes off. And so give you an idea of how simple this is again. Let's just plug this in again. And hopefully, if all goes well, it'll just start up again. So yeah, you just saw it appear on here.
So,
it'll go over.
you disconnected it or you turned it off from the from that menu?
When I turned it off from the menu, that was disconnecting it, like ejecting a drive, basically.
Okay, but so the drive is still technically running on the box here.
Right.
So you'd have to shut this down if you really wanted to shut it down, power it off here.
Oh, yeah, yes. Okay. But the nice thing, you know, it didn't really seem to be drawing power when it was, you know, if you wait long enough, like the fans and everything will cool off, it goes completely silent, which is nice. But basically, that's it. It's ready to go. If you want to get the best performance out of it, you know, use the external monitor entirely. And that's the, you know, because you're still pulling with this one here. But this one, it focuses it all. And now this is solely being powered by the external graphics processing unit. And look at that. That's it. You know, a lot of this was chat. That's basically all it took. So if you're interested in the Razer Core X, that's all there really is to it. Basically, all you missed was me taking it out of the box. So
what else? Benchmarks, how good is it? Where can we find that?
Well, I do have an article. We'll have a review posted tomorrow. And I do have an article talking about eGPUs previously. The thing is I didn't really see any significant differences over the Akitio Node Pro chassis that we were using before, which actually cost a little bit more money. I believe it's $349. When I was using some of the benchmarks here, you know, it was basically amounting to the same. Games that would struggle to get about 30 frames per second, like Rise of the Tomb Raider on native on here, were suddenly getting like 60 and stuff. But because I'm using the same card, I was basically getting the same performance. I thought when I was watching the benchmark, like it was faster or something, but when the actual results came in, it was about the same. So, you know, that's one way to look at it. Your performance is going to vary depending on what kind of card you have on here. And if you have like the Vega 64 or something like that, it's really strong, you'll be seeing something better than that. But once again, with Macs, only AMD is supported, and just a small selection of them. You can look at my review to see that, or you can go to Apple's own support page or Razer's. Nice thing is, if you own PC, you know, you have access to everything else, so NVIDIA and all that stuff, and you can pretty much stick anything you want to in here. But the thing I love most about the Razer Core X is that, you know, it's kind of a forward-thinking device. It's very utilitarian, very simple, but it's got the power supply to handle beefy cards that may come out in the future. It's got the slots for it, and so this is something that you could end up using for a long time. And once again, it's a good way, you know, not only to get better graphics performance out of a unit like a MacBook Pro, but it can also, you know, make it something like an iMac or something last longer than it normally would, because you have more, you know, up-to-date graphics power powered by something else. So it's, in some ways you could argue it's kind of like a toy or something like that. It's an expensive one, but that's it. That's how easy it is to set up. And we'll see you over at Macworld. We'll